they should be proud of yourself, okay?
Not be crazy.
I hope you go to Legoland or Disney.
I think they should learn new things.
Be an engineer so they could build more houses and stuff.
Get a cupcake.
Let's see. They should either go to college or they should, get a job.
I think that they should turn into a police officer or something because you don't want bad guys around.
Had hard work and them are the best people of a Kinley school.
Get a job. Get a good job.
They should study how balloons work.
Maybe when they graduate from school, maybe they could get a job at Wendy because they're nice.
Have some fun for a little bit because you have to work hard for school.
Go to a restaurant. Celebrate?
They should go to college.
Have a party.
They should work at Disneyland because you can make anime songs.
They can graduate and have a party in their class.
They should probably go to college.
They should go to, make a job. Like, maybe you can fix, tires, cars, and you can do makeup, lots of other things.
Be a taxi driver so they can give people a lift if they don't have cars.
Have cake.
I love them and I wish them have so much fun with them both friends.
My wishes.
They could be rich.
Try your best, never give up.
And have a good day.
My wish is for to play together and have fun.
Be happy and proud.
I hope they do a good job.
They have a really great day.
I wish that they do good when they're grown-ups.
I wish to help everybody to be kind, respect each other.
I wish that they can always be happy.
I wish that they'll get real good grades. And I also wish that they'll try their best.
You'll do really great, and I bet your teachers will miss you.
To have a good life.
To have a wonderful day at school.
Be a good student.
I wish they had a great day when they graduated.
You can do it.
Woohoo!
By your parents.
I wish them to have a good life, and God's always on their side.
Congratulations!
Thank you.
Everyone, please rise for the presentation of the colors and the Pledge of Allegiance, and remain standing for the national anthem. Place your right hand over your heart. Ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Be seated.
Good evening, families, friends, members of the staff and community, and most importantly, graduates of the class of 2023. My name is Kate Van Leuven, and I am very honored to be the principal of Redlands High School. Today, all 508 of you are the 130th graduating class of Redlands High School, and the 93rd class to graduate at the Redlands Bowl. We are fortunate to have our Board of Education and our district administration included in this ceremony today. It is my pleasure to present School Board President Melissa Ayala Quintero, Vice President Alex Vara, Clerk Patty Holahan, and members Jim O'Neill and Michelle Rendler. Also joining us from the district office to celebrate the class of 2023 are interim superintendent Patrick Kelly, incoming superintendent Juan Cabral, and assistant superintendents Sabine Robertson Phillips and Jason Hill, and Julie Swan, director of secondary education. Graduation is a team effort, and certainly was this year just as much as ever. Endless thanks to the members of the Redlands High School Graduation Committee for volunteering to work countless hours to make this graduation come to fruition for these most deserving young adults. I would also like to acknowledge the parents, family, and friends who are joining us this evening. You have played an integral part in the accomplishments we're recognizing tonight. Redlands High School is grateful that you've trusted us to spend the last 4 years with your children. Class of 2023, throughout your years at Redlands High School, you have demonstrated the power of small acts. Each achievement, no matter how big or small, has contributed to the collective success of the class of 2023. From earning academic honors to winning championships, to even getting out of bed every morning and just making it to school. Every step forward has been a result of your dedication and determination. Every achievement, every accolade that I am about to mention came from a long series of very small acts, very small defeats, and very small victories. The smallest act can even bring someone into the light. There's a student in your class, most of you probably know him. His brother George passed on a tradition after he graduated to his younger brother, Gideon Pakpahan. Every time Gideon sees me on campus, he says, "Hey, Mrs. Van Leuven, it's your favorite student," with the biggest smile on earth. And every time you said that to me, Gideon, that small act brought brightness to a sometimes dark day. Never stop those small acts. It is often said that greatness is not achieved overnight, but through a series of small actions taken consistently. The countless hours spent studying, practicing, and honing your skills may have seemed insignificant at the moment, but they have collectively propelled you to the heights of success where you are today. And wow, class of 2023, you have a ton of accomplishments. Here we go. Terriertown is thankful that it was honored in two ways this year. RHS is listed as number 3 public high school in our county by niche.com, an overall ranking top 8% of high schools nationwide. U.S. News and World Report ranked Redlands High School in the top 9% of all high schools in the nation. Here is a list of accomplishments by your class. 224 out of the 508 of you earned Golden State Merit Seal diplomas. That is incredible. Among you are 92 CSF Life members honored with gold cords. 122 of you are wearing gold tassels tonight, signifying high honors, meaning that you had a 4.0 or higher since your freshman year. Eight out of the 508 of you earned the California Seal of Biliteracy, representing 8 different languages. And taking their place in the long blue line, representing Redlands High School, our 3 National Merit Scholarship finalists, Isabella Faroki, Varun Srivastava, and Neha Vijay. As for the top 5 ranking students in the class of 2023, I am honored to acknowledge Kaden Roloff, Shriya Narayanan, Neha Vijay, Varun Srivastava, and Isabella Faroki. The class of 2023 features hundreds of student athletes. Here is a snapshot of their contributions. Terrier fans cheered the following sports to CBL championships this year: boys golf, boys tennis, boys swimming, girls volleyball, boys volleyball, and badminton, with 8 teams moving on to CIF playoffs. And finally, one Terrier was just this week named a CIF champion of character, and that is Caden Henderson. Caden not only displays every characteristic that we hope for in an RHS student athlete, but he also raises funds for the Loma Linda Children's Hospital and successfully raised over $20,000 just this year. The hallmark of a Terrier athlete is one who succeeds both on the field and in the classroom. Here are some great examples. Faith Diano and Cam Hobson were Redlands High School's Ken Hubbs Award winners for 2023. And this year's Sabata Athletes of the Year for RHS were Isabella Faroki and Ethan DeVera. This year, and this is the highest number on record for Redlands High School, 7 students were honored with Bobby Cora Awards: Aiden Arient, Ayana Harris, Madeline Pearl, Mariana Ryan, Zachary Steinman, Alex Sumarley, and Jaden Wee. This award goes to an athlete who maintains a cumulative GPA of 4.25 and plays 2 varsity sports. Quite the feat. Finally, I would like to mention one very incredibly special senior who could not be with us tonight. George Rafla is a member of your class, the class of 2023. George is fighting a life-threatening illness and is not well enough to join us tonight. But he is with us here on the live stream. And don't worry, a group of RHS folks a few weeks ago brought graduation to George and his family. And other than them, the most excited person, well, fur person, that was there was his little dog named Bruce Wayne. Bruce Wayne was more excited to see us and more proud of George than anyone else in the room. That seemingly small act of Bruce Wayne supporting George while he earned all of his high school credits while incredibly sick is one of those small acts that can inspire us all. George Rafla, you are with us here tonight. School activities are part of the rich history of our Long Blue Line, and almost every single student in this class has been a part of at least one. Here are some highlights from your senior year. Thanks to LCAP funding, all associated student body entrance fees to events created an environment where everyone could participate. A seemingly small act resulted in the following: 87% of our students were involved in activities and events on our campus, the highest engagement in the history of Redlands High School. 71% of our student body attended 2 or more events. At the first football game this year, 1,132 students attended. Our homecoming dance hosted 1,349 students. Genesis finally happened again this year with over 3,000 students in attendance from Redlands, Rev, Citrus Valley, and Orangewood all together. And RHS won the first annual Hot Cocoa Mug of War against Rev and CV, which gave out free hot cocoa to students in a battle against the other 2 high schools. Lots of fun. RASB bleeds blue, and everyone at RHS is thankful for your contributions. Our academic decathlon team placed 2nd in the county competition this year with our mock... Go ahead. With our mock trial team placing 5th in San Bernardino County, with multiple students earning individual awards. Your speech and debate team qualified 24 students to compete at the state level, and 10 of those are moving on to compete at Nationals in Arizona later this month. Your varsity cheer team placed second at Nationals this year, and our mascots won Nationals. You may not be aware, but Redlands High School had a competitive esports team for the first time ever this year. Our valiant team knocked away all local competition and was invited to compete at the high school esports team's national finals in Kansas City, Missouri, and they did not disappoint. They beat the national championships and placed second in the United States. Congratulations. We have honored our nation, led by our amazing AFJ ROTC color guard at games, rallies, and events. They've truly become part of the fabric of the Long Blue Line. This year, our Macchio yearbook students worked hard to produce a keepsake themed The Uncommon Thread that mirrors the wonderful seniors that it features. Our Hibachi seniors should be proud of their accomplishments as well. Congratulations to Caden Henderson, who ran his own column in the Inland Empire Community News. Our very own Heart Academy graduated 41 seniors this year, with 12 of those seniors completing their certified nursing assistant licenses, and 2 earning their medical assistant certification. We also had 47 amazing seniors graduate from our AVID program. Thank you so much to each of the groups I've mentioned for continuing the tradition of success at RHS. The arts have also been a large part of your identity as Terriers. Here are some highlights. Our theater arts company presented multiple performances this year in our own Clock Auditorium, including the Children's Theater Festival, Treasure Island, and Trap. Our chamber singers performed at the World Strides Seattle Heritage Choral Festival and swept the competition, as you can see, taking home gold, first in the chamber choir division, an adjudicator award, and the Outstanding Choir Award. Les Chanteuses performed at the World Strides San Francisco Heritage Choral Festival and swept the competition, taking home gold first in the treble choir division, gold first in the show choir division, 2 adjudicator awards, and the Outstanding Choir Award. Senior Chloe Loken also took home the Ovation Award for her amazing solo performance. In the area of visual arts, seniors Omola Dajai, Cleo Crone, Morgan Stewart, Eli Snow White, and Aaliyah Lopez were featured in the Young Artist Gallery of San Bernardino County. And Leo Adams earned an honorable mention in his entry at the Redlands Art Association Chalk Competition. Every concert and event that we attend, we are thankful for our musical Terriers. Our instrumental music program was quite accomplished. Our marching band qualified for state championships for the first time ever and placed 13th. Yeah! In addition, for the 19th consecutive year, all performing concert groups earned unanimous superior ratings. Yeah! And we cannot forget that our own Nathan Allegre was selected as first trumpet in the All Southern California High School Honor Wind Ensemble, and Skylar Park earned first chair in All County Honor Band for alto saxophone. So many of you have actually known since you were born, Emily Pearl, Roland Dockham, to name a few. The small acts I've seen all of you do since you were little tiny kids makes me incredibly proud today. And those are some incredibly amazing facts about your class. And for that, we thank you. But what we are most thankful for, class of 2023, is that together, you have the power to create positive change, one small act at a time. Like you always have, embrace the opportunities that come your way, and never forget that even the smallest gestures can have a profound impact on the life of others. Congratulations, graduates, on the power of your collective small acts, and may they continue to help you along in your journey. In a short time, after we have heard the wonderful speeches from Ryan G. and Hallie Keating, and our teacher message from Mr. Wilder, and after we have heard the names of each one of our 508 graduates this evening, the lights will dim. Everyone in the audience will quiet. You will sing your alma mater together for the last time. And when you hear those carillon bells sound ringing for you, know that you will join your place in the long blue line. Congratulations, class of 2023.
Before I begin, I'd like to extend a couple of thank yous. To my parents, thank you for raising me to be the person I am today. I couldn't imagine growing up in any other environment without the continuous support you all give me every single day and the space you provide me to be myself. To my brother, my cousins, my extended family, and my friends, thank you for showing me that every relationship, even when temporary, can create lasting memories no matter how much life changes. To the speech and debate team, thank you for allowing me to have the confidence to even be on this stage in the first place. These past 4 years would not have been the same without a family at school I can run back to. To all the faculty, staff, and teachers, to Mrs. De La Cruz, Mrs. Freibot, Mrs. Sanders, Mr. Jaxtus, Mr. Comedina, Mr. Smith, Mr. Walker, Mr. Wilder, Mr. DeVoe, Mr. Gawley, and Mr. Benanti. Thank you for making all of our educational experiences not only bearable, but also enjoyable. And to Aiden Arians, thank you for giving me $5 to shout you out before my speech. I wouldn't have had the motivation to strive towards success if it wasn't for your kind donation and generous philanthropy. So Aiden, this one's for you. All right, here we go. 4 years ago, we all entered high school with one goal in mind: to reach this very stage, grab our diplomas, follow all of our teachers on Instagram, and start the next chapter of our lives. But as much as we all could have imagined this moment in our heads, none of us could have predicted the how. For a lot of us, it could have been starting off feeling lost to now feeling accepted. For the select few of you, it could have been entering high school 5'1" to now leaving 5'2". You all know who you are. But regardless of how much you've changed, it's important to note how quickly our lives can change with a single shift. And I'm not talking about the aggregate supply line, or coincidentally, the only broken key on your Chromebook. I'm talking about the breakups, the transitions, the president projects Mr. Wilder swears will only take 2 seconds. And the changes we encounter on a daily basis. But as we shift from high school to what lies ahead, it's important to realize that there will always be uncertainty about the future. And whether you like it or not, life keeps moving forward. It's a remorseless force that gives, but also takes away. We've all been asked the question at some point, where do you see yourself in 10 years? You know, some of us may be millionaires, some of us may be dead. But the point is, the same faces you see sitting around you right now may not be the same faces you see ever again. Your whole reality can alter so quickly. Like, remember that one year we were all on Zoom? Yeah, me neither. But no one could have predicted the pandemic to hit us as hard as it did. The lives we lived before completely changed in an instant. Many of us can relate to the feeling of being depressed, uncertain, or isolated. Maybe even experiencing the pain of losing a loved one who could have shared the special moments with us at graduation. You see, throughout life, we're all going to encounter shifts of varying magnitude. And it could be scary. But if there's one thing I'm sure about, it's that the class of 2023 has always come back stronger. Because remember, it's never about the inevitable challenges that you will face, but rather it's what you make of them. It is never too late, no matter the stage of life you're at. And I'm not saying that because I was late to second period every day. Sorry, Mr. Smith. But I'm saying that because it's true. It is never too late to change. What's important is that we learn to live life aiming for what could be instead of regretting what's already been done. And I mean, as you all know, that just like the center of the dance floor at homecoming, the grind never stops. Graduates, we are at the biggest shift of our lives thus far. So my only advice to everyone is, keep going. Do what you feel is right. Keep fighting for what you believe in. Stand up when others won't. Unless it's on one of the roller coasters at grad night tomorrow, because in that case, please remain seated. They say you forget 95% of what you learn in high school. But you are never going to forget the people, the memories, the growth, and the perseverance it took to get to this moment that made your high school experience worthwhile. You will never forget when our varsity football team won the Smudge Pot, not only our freshman year, but also our senior year, allowing us to not only start on a dub, but end on one as well. You will never forget the wedding we held in the middle of lunch. You will never forget the pep rallies that gave each and every one of us permanent damage to our eardrums. And you will never forget singing that alma mater one last time. So whenever you encounter a roadblock, a setback, or a shift in your life, don't view it as a wall blocking your path, but see it through as a window of opportunity. Class of 2023, we made it.
Why some pain. Oh, why do we refuse to hang a light when the streets are dangerous? Why does it take an accident before the truth gets through to us? Cages or wings, which do you prefer?
What does it take to wake up a generation? How can you make someone take off and fly if we don't wake up and shake up the nation? We'll eat the dust of the world.
Wow, that is a lot of people. Okay. Hello, class of 2023. I would like to begin by first thanking my parents for their constant encouragement, guidance, and most importantly, for keeping the coffee pot full. And a second thank you, of course, is due to all of the educators, both here and not in attendance, because none of us would be here without their work. With that said, well, here goes nothing. Today's the day my life begins. Today, I become a grown-up. Today, I become accountable to the world, to the future. And had I wanted to copy the writers of Grey's Anatomy, this would have been the perfect graduation speech. But seeing as that could have ended very badly, well, it leads me to wonder. How many of you signed the academic integrity policy? Anyone? No one? Yeah, I see you guys. Well, for those of you who don't know, it's the one that tells us not to plagiarize, all work should be our own, that we should never ask our friend for the answers to that calc assignment that we couldn't do because, well, We were at a concert until 2 in the morning. Yeah, it's that thing. And I'm sure all of you who raised your hands adhered to it. But here's the problem. High school is one big work of plagiarism. We come into high school thinking we know who we are. We arrive on this campus with our heads held high, our backpack straps on both shoulders, and our shoes unscathed by the English steps. Not anymore, but it's okay. At the ripe old age of 14, we've decided our futures. We know who we're going to be, right? Wrong. Yeah, we know nothing. And so we make friends, and we commiserate about the timed right that we had on the very first day of school. Thank you, Mrs. Flowers. And we learn. We adapt. The people we are, they change. And not just through our experiences, but through the people we meet. We take our favorite parts of our friends, the parts only we know, and we make them facets of who we are. And then we don't tell them, yeah, which sounds a little familiar, doesn't it? I look at all of you and know without a doubt that we are not the class of 2023 today that we were as freshmen. We're better, because every single person we've talked to, everyone we've met, has changed us. Now, I'm a student, first and foremost, but I am also a product of the people I have met along this journey, just like all of you. I am Mrs. Freibot's ability to nerd out. I am Mr. Wagner's fifth period know-it-all, and to all of the people who took that class with me, my most sincere apologies. Even still, I'm a chamber singer, and I am Mr. Diaz's attention to detail. Hey, Diaz. Unfortunately, were the list to go on, we'd be here all night, so I really hope you get the picture. I carry with me the impact of everyone I've ever met, as do each of you. If you think I'm wrong, go ahead. Look around. There is someone here who made you laugh, made you cry, or made you smarter. There is someone here who, after knowing them for a while, you realized you had become kinder because they were kind to you. You realized you had become wiser, because they, too, were wise. So, we plagiarize. We make parts of other people into parts of ourselves. And hopefully, we become better for it. Hopefully, we learn how to see the value of others. We become kinder, and we become more knowledgeable, more relatable, even. When we leave here today, we'll be different. We'll be high school graduates. And who we are, well, that's bound to change too. We're probably not going to remember everyone. We're probably not going to keep in touch with every single person who made us laugh. But the next time you look at yourself in the mirror, I hope you can see what you have gained from the people around you today. Because I can guarantee you this, you have grown because of them. In 20 years, yeah, maybe we won't remember these faces, but we will always have the parts of ourselves that resemble those who've helped us these past 4 years. Keep growing, keep changing, and keep plagiarizing, just not in your essays.
Thank you.
be okay. You have more friends than you know.
Settle down. Let's lower expectations. All right. Here we go. All right. Here we go. Ananya was my TA, one of my TAs this year, and she didn't think I would have a speech ready to go, but Ananya, I do. Okay? Although, I'll be honest, this was one of the more difficult tasks of my career. By its very definition, this is a charge, a call to action by a faculty member to the graduating class of 2023. Ananya also thought I was going to say 24, but I said 23. We're good, okay? But as a speaker, you want to say something that will resonate with this group of seniors long after tonight's parties have commenced. So what can I say that will be impactful? I'm not going to lie, I had writer's block for a few weeks. So I asked my family for advice. My wife said have a central theme. Okay, I can do that. My oldest daughter said make it funny. Okay, I'll try. My youngest daughter said, talk about pigs. So to recap, we have a funny speech thematically based on pigs, right? But that won't work. My wife was right, though. She said, we need a central theme. So I started to think, what event defined your class of 2023? And then it hit me. The pandemic. Right? Yeah, no, hold on, right? Hold on. Okay, now, I started to think. There have been a million speeches on the pandemic. What could I say new to the graduating class about this monumental event? And then I thought more. There have been a million speeches on the pandemic. What if I took the best of those speeches and gave them to the best graduating class in the nation? Here we go. A student from Brandeis University told her peers, let's walk into the scorched field of the world we knew and replace the brittle dirt of society with the fresh soil of possibility and imagination. That sounds inspiring, right? The speaker from Wilton High School graduation told the audience, the pandemic did not erase our teenage achievements, nor did the pandemic destroy our spirits and talents. It simply diverted them to new pursuits. I concur. From Everett High School in Alabama, despite the uncertainty looming over our heads for the past few years, we've been able to overcome every insane obstacle that came our way, but we were not able to jump over those tribulations alone. Long blue line. And so I continued to scour different sources and speeches, and I realized that I had created with the help of others, the greatest graduation speech of all time. A couple of days ago, Mrs. Dockham, one of our assistant principals, asked to see my speech. I just assumed that she was afraid that I wasn't going to say, she was trying to make sure I wouldn't say anything too controversial. No problem, ma'am. Here's my speech. Try not to be blinded by its greatness. She called me this morning. For those who don't know, here at Redlands High School, we have this thing called turnitin.com. It can track phrases and sentences from different websites to make sure students are not taking the work of others without giving proper credit. Mrs. Dockham informed me that my speech was a 98% match for plagiarism. She wanted answers. So did I. Where did that 2% come from? She wanted to know why I would so vagrantly take others' ideas for a graduation speech. For goodness sake, her son is graduating tonight. This is important. So what did I tell her? How did I appear before you after this blatant plagiarism? I told Ms. Dockham I was just trying to make sure the system worked. Because as we know, the class of 2023 put that system into overdrive. No, I'm kidding. I do have a real speech. I do. I wrote it on the way here. I'm kidding to all the officers in the crowd. My AP English language teacher from high school, Mr. McNeil, the finest teacher I will ever know, said that every teacher's goal for every year, for every student, should be to leave them with two major lessons and a mystery. At the time, I had no idea what he meant. But I would eventually find out, and I hope by the end of the night, it'll be clear to you as well. I will borrow from his strategy, and by trade, I am a historian. We like to tell stories, so I hope you will allow me that allowance today in this senior charge. So, my first piece of advice for the senior class is, be authentic. And not the fake sort of follower way. You know when one person says, I hate this class, and you all nod your head in agreement and go, yeah, me too? Not that type of way, okay? That's the Rotten Tomatoes way to go through life. No, I'm talking about the sort of individual realism that only you can identify. The type that may or may not go against popular opinion. I'll give you an example. At my high school graduation, the student selected to speak was the valedictorian, the student with the highest grade point average for the 4 years in high school. My graduating class had two speakers because there was a mathematical tie. And I know what you're thinking. Who tied with you, Mr. Wilder, to give that graduation speech, right? Sadly, I was not in the top two, and if we're being honest, you could have picked the top 200 students up here to speak, and I still would have been in the audience. As fate would have it, the two students who were chosen to speak were boyfriend and girlfriend. Right? Let's call them Jennifer and Michael. Ironically, Jennifer was my ex-girlfriend. And Michael was the guy who used to be my friend before he started dating Jennifer. Stop, right? Stop. True story. I sat there for 15 minutes as they professed their love to one another. Adults were visibly moved in the audience. My own mother, who saw me agonize over this breakup, started to cry. She pointed at me. She said, "Why did you mess things up with that girl? That could have been you. That should be you. You could be a doctor." Sorry, Mom, but it all worked out because I'm here with the class of 2023. Now, near the end of this speech, one of my friends turned to me and he said, "Isn't this the best thing you've ever heard?" And the right thing to say was yes, or smile politely, or nod my head, but instead I said, "No, this is horrible." My friend gave me the ugliest side eye in the history of mankind, but I immediately felt better. The last thing I wanted to hear was for two people who used to be very prominent in my life talk about how much better theirs was without me. So what's the lesson? Be true to yourself. In a world where we monitor the number of likes on Instagram, hold dear to our streaks on Snapchat, and do our best to be real, I suggest you focus on your own reality. What makes you happy? What's your truth? Who are you before you add the filter and the location? At the end of the day, those who truly know you are more important than any image you can craft to show the digital world. These are dangerous times. The truth matters more than ever. If you cannot be true to yourself, how can you protect the truth for others? It's a lot easier to tackle a bunch of side eyes when you can look at yourself in the mirror. Second objective, be optimistic. If I may, another story. In 1992, my hometown of Los Angeles was engulfed in one of the ugliest urban riots in the history of the United States. Now, my neighborhood was no picnic before the riots. In fact, my parents sent my brother and I to a different school in an affluent area. Now, the reason why these riots happened was there was a verdict in the case involving the LAPD and the accusation that they had used excessive force against a man they pulled over, Rodney King. The officers were not found guilty, or found not guilty, and within hours of the announcement, my city was on fire. The resulting days would see massive destruction, looting, physical violence. It got so bad that the National Guard was brought in and a curfew was installed. I was 12 years old at the time. I had no idea what was happening. The one thing I knew was that my father was scared and I had never seen that before. The next day, a friend from school, Bradley, called. He said he had been watching the riots on television and he wanted to see if I was okay. Bradley asked if I wanted to stay with he and his family in Woodland Hills until the riots were finished. I told him there was no way that I could leave my family. He said that I misunderstood. He was inviting my entire family to stay with his until the riots had ceased. I was flabbergasted by his generosity. My parents had never met Bradley's, but they were offering us a refuge from this crisis. So happy ending, right? Not exactly. When I told my dad about Bradley's offer, he scoffed and said that he wouldn't accept help from people he didn't know. Even though he didn't say it, I knew that it was more than that. My father had grown up in the 1950s and the 1960s, a troubling time for this nation's racial history. He had seen things, incidences that I've largely been blessed to avoid, that had hardened his opinion in people. He had lost his faith in humanity. So what's the lesson? Remain optimistic. Things are going to happen to you. People will mistreat you and disrespect you. They will build bridges and burn them down. It's my guess that you will encounter some pretty horrible people and there will be difficult times. The truth is, everybody fails. Sometimes. What's more important is what you do next. Don't wallow in failures and disappointments. If you pay attention to what is said on social media or the news, it's pretty easy to be pessimistic. Ignore all that. Their goal is to focus on what divides us. A person is not necessarily defined by gender or race, who they vote for every 4 years, their favorite news channel, or the month of celebration they most identify with. Wake up each day hopeful about the possibility that you will see the best of humanity. And if there are days where you don't, let it go and think about the potential of tomorrow. In other words, if you have a choice, and you always do, be Bradley. So, back to Mr. McNeil. Two lessons and a mystery. What did he mean? One day we were reading The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn. McNeil decided that we would read the climax of the novel silently, around 5 pages in length. As I neared the assignment where Huck Finn decides to live an authentic and optimistic life, I mouthed, "Oh, don't worry, I won't make history being the first faculty member to curse during a speech." But I said a really bad word. I looked at Mr. McNeil and he matched my gaze. He just smiled and then I got it. I had found my mystery. He didn't know what it was, and I never told him, but that feeling of being set up to learn and understanding things at a deeper level, I was addicted. I realized in that moment that I wanted to have that feeling for the rest of my life. I love my job. I laugh more in a single day in my classroom than most teachers do in a year, and that's because of all of you. More than ever, I know how blessed I am. So, what will your mystery be? What will inspire you to wake up each morning and be better than the day before? Most of you probably have no idea, and I certainly don't, but I cannot wait for you to find out. So if you end up being a doctor, lawyer, carpenter, social media influencer, history teacher, landscaper, amusement park attendant, life coach, flight attendant, member of the armed forces, zoologist, biologist, chemist, superhero, civil engineer, dog walker, secret service member, congressperson, animal balloon specialist, museum curator, video game designer, actor, director, mother, father, or all of the above, do so authentically and with great optimism. Because the last thing you want to do is one day wake up and realize that your life has been flagged by Turnitin.com for plagiarism with little hope for the future. Class of 2023, I salute you. I applaud you. I will miss you. Thank you so, so much for this opportunity. It's all love. It's always love. Thank you.
At this time, I am honored to introduce Mrs. Melissa Ayala Quintero, President of the Board of Education. Mrs. Ayala Quintero, members of the Board of Education, and Superintendent Kelly, the members of the class here with us today have fulfilled all of the requirements of the State of California and the local school board, and are therefore eligible to receive their diplomas. It is indeed my pleasure and honor to present to you this most wonderful class of Redlands High School, class of 2023.
Thank you, Principal Van Leeuwen. As representative of the Board of Trustees of the Redlands Unified School District, I am both honored and privileged to receive this incredible class of 2023 from Redlands High. Graduates, take a moment to reflect on your time at RHS. From your first step on our campus, you've not only grown academically, but personally. You have shown us that you can overcome obstacles and you have emerged much stronger. As you stand here, know that you are equipped with the knowledge, skills, and passion necessary to make a difference in this world. So embrace challenges, chase your dreams, and never cease in your pursuit of knowledge and personal growth. And as you move forward, don't forget to thank those in your life that helped you get here and to aid those that needed along the way. You are now and forever a part of the rich history of RHS and the Long Blue Line. And with that, I am very pleased to announce that from this day forth, you are no longer RUSD students, but now graduates of Redlands High School. Congratulations, Terriers!
Before we begin, every family and every group of friends is proud of their graduate tonight, but every family and group of friends has the right to hear their graduate's name heard, so we ask you to keep that in mind as the roll call proceeds.
Muse Choi.
Michelle Harianja.
Hallie Keating.
Ryan G.
Sophia Elizabeth Tucker.
Aiden Orient.
Trevor Hernandez.
Ananya Anand.
Grace Renee Sanchez.
Asher Lawson.
Ryan Yin.
Fanuk Saeed.
Jonathan Daniel Edgar Sumante.
Aditi Palola.
Angela Marie Caldoza Mercado.
Aaron Bautista.
Whitney Hagstead.
Ethan Kwan.
Eunice Jane Salvador.
Aaron Morgenthaler.
Katrina Behringer.
Shada Shahmohammadi.
Sophia Amor Cruz.
Morgan Stewart.
Charlize Jade Harlan.
Vanessa Muckloof.
Andrea Elizabeth Adam.
Natalie Cho.
Alicia Nikki Julu.
Lara Pauline Lassifakar.
Joshua Ramirez Rios.
Kata Stalbert.
Gavin Duenes.
Abigail Trujillo.
Christina Ortega.
Jacob Marion.
Sophia Ruiz.
Jacob William Bennett.
Sherry Sinde.
Ethan Big E Olivares.
Leon Ray Abalos.
Nina Zurich.
Caden Roloff.
Garrett Snyder.
Orume Ibako.
Mia Gonzalez.
Jordan Woods.
John Hudson.
Vincent Blancas.
Francesca Mercado.
Jordan Zamora.
Ana Mendoza.
Gerardo Howe.
Daniela Montes.
Uman Lockheed.
Mariana Ryan.
Jaden Woods.
Mia Brubaker.
Emma Nicole Quesada.
Jordan Kira Eden.
Venecia Uribe.
Sophia Romo.
Wanzi Tan.
Wendy Esmeralda Alvarez Mateo.
Rhea Carvey.
Annabelle Escobar.
Olamadi Ajayi.
Samantha Gutierrez.
Mark Saptaji.
Itzel Sandoval.
Justin Nguyen.
Emma Flannery.
Pablo Prado.
Lucy Valencia.
Rachel Anderson.
Justine Tovar.
Sophia Pelugi.
Giovanni Brown.
Jay Shank.
Jenna Uribe.
Brian Sierra.
Cheyenne Gradias.
Sabino Ramos.
Jeremy Brown.
Jacob Parvin.
Nathan Barker.
Alberto Villegas.
Tristan Harbert.
Derek Martinez.
Kane Smith.
Rodham Kalamanovich.
Claudia Kostinski.
Aiden Bedley.
Lovely Burnell.
Liam Pablo.
Will Ross.
Anthony Ortega.
Ella Rose Shergold.
Aaron Stevens.
Ivan Goward.
Marilyn Rojas.
Leah Amani Harris.
Noe Uvalle.
Caitlin Sarah Hopkins.
Ana Luisa Pires.
Janelle Nicole Suarez.
Louis Borja Jesse.
Samantha Luvana Thomas.
Gideon Pakpahan.
Ethan DeVera.
David Swinda.
Jason Nangolan.
Timothy Tindin.
Emmanuel Wiesong.
Mark Anyan Cruz Collip.
Arief Mungusong.
Sean Sam.
Ethan Marco Mina.
Brinkley Devlin.
Ricardo Diaz de Leon.
Cameron Hobson.
Jacob Garcia.
Khalid Abugari Alhomsi.
Joey Chong.
Winston Mondong.
Christian Chaparasa.
Orion Tenja.
Xavier Brambala.
Aryan Putnam.
Suzanne Calcina Croto.
Alyssa Ramirez.
Kelly Cation Nip.
Gwyneth Tager.
Gabriella Stephanie.
Isaiah Silva.
Gregory Deception Taguinis.
Carla Ibrahim.
Javier King Flores III.
Gian Gomez.
Mason Duke.
Abigail Lumbangol.
Emmanuel Garcia Olivas.
Yasmin Barahona.
Natalie Guzman.
Jane Nebajo.
Jennifer Lizeth Lopez Avalos.
Rasha Tungjungya.
Arleth Diaz De Leon Chavez.
Kayleen Lim.
Kiara Choi.
Jacqueline Limbong.
Faith Diano.
Victoria Van Stee.
Ayana Isadora Harris.
Isabella Axel Rose Chote Padilla.
Shreya Narainan.
Alex McCurdy.
Gavin Estevez Wong.
Zoe McDuffie.
Ricky Zabala.
Alex Schroeder.
Ferris Khatib.
Rian Fargava.
Ahmed Khatib.
Brandon Kirk.
Caden Henderson.
Akshay Balaji.
Miraj Parekh.
Kevin Shishirk.
Muhan Adami.
Marco Mora.
Robert Venegas.
Alex Vega Castillo.
Nicholas Sangari.
Estefania Escalante Hernandez.
Jamal Alarda.
Thomas Van Esch.
Amar Bajri.
Alex Brown.
Saul Cervantes.
Sandra Hani Dawood.
Nicholas Fernandez.
Isabella Parisa Faruqi.
Gabriel Carino.
Varun Srivastava.
Roman Jimenez.
Peyton Wall.
Roger Edwin Cialvo III.
Violet Farragher Holman.
Hedy Joyce Alabing.
Ava Rania Somarna.
Vanessa Michelle Zarate.
Krista Jusica.
William Stroger.
Khalid Mossad.
Myrna Tawadris.
Michaela Cherie Cross.
Ella Maffei.
Clarice Najapur.
Malade Vilakana.
Jason Lowe.
Rosalind Lopez.
Jaden Wee.
Eric Chen.
Kaylee Ellis.
Dexter Shu.
Brianne Aguilar.
Christopher Pham.
Sabrina Hajid.
Jamari Willis.
Wyatt Miner.
Amaris Suhala Ishak.
Samuel Wells.
Genesis Michaela Ishak.
Diego Jimenez.
Linda Digwo.
Colin Jackson.
Brenda Digwo.
Jordan Santana.
Haley Croker.
Hanalei Martinez.
Juliana Sophia Amenda.
Alden Weefels.
Mahogany Rodriguez.
Brian Sanchez.
Monique Salas.
Hosong Cheng.
Jason Velasquez.
Viviana Lopez.
Aaron Oldicari.
Doha Shawaka.
Daniela Cervantes.
Jamie Daniela Escobar Mayen.
Jocelyn Arenas Salazar.
Christiana Marie Johnson.
Daniela Salazar.
Arturo Alejandro Cruz.
Alexandra Arroyo.
Aurora Johnson.
Natalie Hernandez.
Nima Farah.
Jennifer Cervantes.
Serenity Lim.
Trevor Sandlin.
Gavino Lamelli.
Ian Schmidt.
Xavier Martinez.
Jaden Ventresca.
Leslie Marie Ramos.
Manuel Amador.
Stephanie Elena Perez.
Michael Hernandez.
Diviana Valiente.
Sebastian Landa.
Montserrat Vargas Chavez.
Maria Gatica.
Esmeralda Morales.
Laura Baden.
Alexandra Sofia Martin.
Eli Snow White.
Caitlin Oth.
Vincent Rivera.
Max Saravia.
Skylar Senyon Park.
Ifatha Sinaga.
Daniel Flynn.
Alexander Sumarli.
Nathan Allegri.
Kosh Mendoza.
Zachary Steinman.
Lisbeth Bentancur Barrios.
Neha Vijay.
Chloe Doss.
Ariana Elaine Amada Stevens.
Benjamin Chambi Perez.
Amber Lucille Garcia.
Aaron Morton.
Cuevas.
Julia Cuevas.
Isaiah Kerr.
Juan Daniel Hernandez.
Paul Perez.
Afifa Mohsen.
Misael Gomez.
Shelby Andrade.
Alyssa Milligan.
Jada Kyra Sampson.
Michelle Clark.
Dayani Clarice Ortiz.
Jimin Kim.
Daniel Alberto Estrada.
Angelina Escobar.
Andrea Duran.
Ryan Jackson.
Alejandra Luna Lopez Venegas.
Charles Goodyear.
Alexander Chalinrath.
Storm Pfeiffer.
Norman Shakma.
Shims Alsamaria.
Jan Ian Benito.
Deisha Marisela Cuevas Partovedo.
Joshua Swanson.
Jaden Lincoln.
Joseph Gill.
Brianna Roa.
Jesus Antonio Portillo Gomez.
Dylan Lurando.
Ethan Giddings.
Leo Armstrong.
Kaylee Joy.
Aaron Lee.
Natalie Ramirez.
Jacqueline Lee.
Lena Torres.
Robert Rom.
Aria Noor.
Grace Esther Mongusong.
Leah McCann.
Laura Gabrielle Massey.
Aubrey Marie Ramsberger.
Kelly Carfendi.
Riley Schrodes.
Bernadette Mancarius.
Rylan Joy.
Carson Blue Garcia.
Jake Casillas.
Elizabeth Kaidel.
Sydney Jennings.
Mason Thomas.
Juliana Love Ramirez.
James Woolley.
Isabella Bell.
You okay, Malika?
Sendejas.
Malachi Madrid.
Kylie Lockhart.
Jair Alejandro Oliva Pais.
Keala Mailani Jose.
Eshpan Rivas.
Jayla Smith.
Aaliyah Lopez.
Nazalia Angela Rodriguez.
Gavin Drake.
Esmeralda Castillo.
Wesley King.
Destiny Fernandez.
Cleo Crone.
Catherine Granados.
Morgan Christensen.
Ariana Chaconas.
Richard Ong.
Michelle Obazi.
Joshua Simon.
Emily Grace Pineda.
Alicia Hassan Bernadine Sinaga.
Ashley Mapes.
Jensen Bracci.
Kiana Schillings.
Alexander Connor Mwenking.
Leila Magana.
Owen Walker.
Trini No.
Giselle Garcia.
PJ Arthur Pineda.
Lucas Gonzalez.
Bryce Lewis.
Puria Adil.
Al Frank Tupas.
Rajpreet Dillon.
Aaron Lantu.
Helena Barron.
Ethan Namsang.
Benjamin Farrell.
Stephen Jerungan.
Christian Bear.
Brittany Suisa.
Seth Shuras.
Emma Weisang.
Roland Dockham.
Sarah Salem.
Adrian Simbalon.
Hasui Mejia.
Andrew Humiston.
Christopher Mayola.
Maddie Brown.
Omatello Ledesma.
Eva Ulani Avila.
Jason Suryadi.
Doña Abuliz.
Gabriela Vargas.
Chanel Yaose Quarteng.
Chloe Loken.
Sanya Shrivostav.
Savina Viarino.
Aaron Hill.
Caitlin Janelle Legespi.
Marissa Grievous.
Daisy Anita Lara.
Christine Krenzel.
Lisbeth Moran.
Delana Harris.
Jessica Bull.
Christiana Krenzel.
Lonnie Castillo.
Andrew Jackson.
Aman Sheikh.
Emiliano Betancourt.
Isabel Cloud.
Isael Gomez Garcia.
Joseph Joaquin Perez.
Aaron Carrero.
Katie Wacker.
Patrick Benton.
Adam Nagy.
Michaelin Wilson.
Andrew Lambert.
Michelle Ali.
Jace Johnson.
Joshua Cho.
Eli Mendez.
Yichen Gao.
Alejandro Ismael Herrera.
Ethan Chan.
Yusef Lachin.
Leanna Claire Silalahi.
Brandon Elizondo.
Evander Burgess.
Stephen Coleman.
Margo Jalen Del Rio.
Jimmy Castañeda.
Thaddeus Jackson Lane.
Emma Grace Ford.
Jaden Avery Bruno.
Sohini Chatterjee.
Jesse Hernandez.
Amory Garcia.
Joshua Mahoney.
Aisha Fordham.
Gilbert Garcia.
Jose Tapia.
Angeline Nicole Asatorian.
Noah Patino.
Anthony Aguilar.
Riley Chavez.
Christian Souza Zamora.
Robbie Mitchell.
Jacob Ambrose.
Samson Lopez.
Josiah Ambrose.
Daniel Mejia.
Cyrus Timbinski.
Jeremiah Valiente.
Benjamin Otter.
Castell Parislo.
Madeline Pearl.
Isaac Mora Garcia.
Gabriel Ismael Gonzalez.
Dylan Shaw.
Fernando Valdez.
Megan Mamarimbing.
Haley Seegers.
Emily Nguyen Tran.
Rachel Shin.
Albert Fong.
Rowan Lee. Chanel Mokar.
Nydia Cortez.
Yuki Miyajima.
Mokhtar Rajab. Mia Davila. Evie Cristerna.
Grace Rosario. Sayumi Amarasingha.
at this time, we will all be singing the alma mater together as the last time the class of 2023. I do want to remind everyone, this is one of the most special things, one of the most special parts of the Redlands High School commencement. Once we have sung the chorus and all of the verses together, the lights will dim and everyone in the crowd will fall silent, and we will be able to hear the last verse of the alma mater on the carillon bells.
Congratulations, class of 2023! Thank you.
graduates.